While the government's net zero plan made headlines, another strategy was quietly launched for COP26, presenting the National Climate Resilience and Adaptation Strategy. It's our national plan to deal with the unavoidable impacts of climate change, like severe weather events and bushfires. Australia's first adaptation strategy from 2015 ranked last out of 54 countries on aligning with the Paris Agreement. But now, it's 6 years later, we've suffered a few disasters, and we've updated the strategy. What have we got? Clear targets? No. Timelines? Nope. Commitments to reduce emissions and prevent disasters from happening in the first place? Definitely not. It does commit to assess national climate risks, maybe sometime in the next 5 or more years. And we need that assessment so that communities aren't left alone to predict rising sea levels and severe weather events. But we need it much, much sooner. We need more than an assessment. We need action. The truth is, even though Australia is experiencing some of the world's worst climate impacts, and despite disasters already annually costing $38 billion, Australia is way behind. Most countries have moved on from aspirational adaptation strategies and are implementing national adaptation plans. At least 106 other countries have national adaptation plans or policies, where Australia doesn't. But the window of opportunity is still open to protect Australians from unfolding climate disasters. Prevention is worth more than a cure, so we need to roll out policies that reduce emissions to protect us from intensifying floods, fires, droughts, and heat waves. Thanks for watching. For more analysis from the Australia Institute, subscribe to australiainstitute.tv.